Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and you're watching a quick shot video. This week, as you can see, I'm not in the studio. I'm at the sea. So we're going to do a photography question. So today's question was sent in by a viewer whose name I can't remember, but never mind, because there's your name right along the bottom of the screen. Perfect. So the question is basically this. I want to do that nice kind of long exposure stuff where you blur out the sea and give it that super silky smooth. How do I do it? Well, I'm going to show you my setup to do exactly that sort of picture. First thing, and by far the most important, is the tripod. A good, sturdy, solid tripod. Can't emphasize how important that is. Get yourself a sturdy set of legs. Next, I'm using a digital SLR. Any camera will work as long as you have control over the shutter, because we want to slow the shutter speed down as much as possible. Now to do that, I'm going to do two tricks. The first one is to use the ISO. The ISO I'm going to lower down to its lowest setting, which in this camera's case is 100 ISO. Next thing I'm going to do is to change the aperture. Now the aperture wants to be as small as possible to let as least amount of light possible in and give you the longest possible shutter speeds. So I'm using aperture priority mode and I'm shooting at f22. So with those settings in, let's see what exposure we get. Okay, at the moment it's about 15-20 minutes before sunset and I'm getting a shutter speed of a quarter of a second, which is quite slow, but not slow enough. We really want to have a shutter speed of, 5 seconds or longer would be perfect. So to slow things down even further, I'm going to use this. Now this is a grey filter. It's not a neutral density filter. If I had one of those, that would be perfect. Instead, this is a polarizing filter. Now you've probably got a polarizing filter already, in which case you can do this with the equipment you already have. If you haven't got a polarizing filter, you know what your next purchase needs to be, an incredibly useful thing. So I'm going to put the polarizing filter on the camera, like that, and then we'll check, see what the exposure has changed to, because that polarizing filter should knock off a couple of stops of light at least. Yeah, okay, so we're down to a second now. So we're getting closer to it. Let's take a picture and see how that looks. That's pretty good. One more tip I can give you, actually, I nearly forgot. Tripping the shutter. Rather than doing it by hand, get yourself one of these, a remote release. If you haven't got one of these, use the self timer. It should just help to alleviate any camera shake that could ruin your picture. Okay, so 1 second, that's pretty good, but I want longer. Now the only way I'm going to get a longer exposure is either to add more polarizing filters or neutral density filters, or just stay here for a little bit longer. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to hang around for a bit, we're going to let the sun go down, and I'm going to take some more pictures. There we go, that's the end result. I hope you enjoy it. If you've got a photography or a Photoshop question you want me to answer, pop along to my website, www.gavtrain.com, fill in the form, and I'll try and answer it here in a video. I'm Gavin Hoey, thanks for watching.